stand up, and I'm going to walk to the podium, and then I'm going to give my speech from the podium. So take just a couple minutes to get set up. Okay, can you bring things over? This is Brad, my assistant. He's going to help me stand today.
General purpose and a specific purpose for the speech, which I've done.
Okay.
And then I can complete the speech.
Okay, so go ahead. Thank you.
Yeah, unfortunately, I'm going to have to repeat some of this as I go along. Okay. When I was first paralyzed in 1998, my doctor told me I would never walk again. 5 years later, I discovered these braces. When I inquired about them, the orthoticist said that my level of injury was too high and I wouldn't be able to use them. I don't like listening to doctors because they're usually not right. So what I did was, is because my desire to walk overcame all of their beliefs, and the past 8 years I've been walking with these several times a week, and including walking over the finish line of 5 LA marathons and about 15 5Ks. There are 3 steps to achieving a goal. Decide what you want to do, then write it down, and then, finally, do it. It's an important step. You too can achieve seemingly impossible things if you put your mind to it. Reach for the stars. If you just get to the clouds, you'll still be better off. The first step is to pick an area of your life you want to either improve, like social skills, to overcome, like fear of telling your boss you don't like what you're doing, or to challenge yourself, as I've done many times. In September 2004, after a year of learning how to walk for the second time in my life, I set a goal to walk across the finish line in the March 2005 LA Marathon. Next, write down the steps you can do to achieve the goal. In late 2004, I contacted the owners of the LA Marathon to ask permission to walk the last few hundred feet of the race. They thought about it. In fact, they thought it was a little crazy, they told me. But after several weeks of going back and forth, they approved of the idea, and they comped me. So it didn't cost me anything, which was nice. Finally, the third step is do it. For the 6 months between the setting of my marathon goal and the event, I practiced walking 5 to 6 days a week, anywhere from 8 to 15 minutes of a piece. Which for me, walking is like doing a, for those of you who aren't aware, walking is like doing a walking handstand, as my arms are my legs. During this time, I transitioned from a walker to forearm crutches, which are really tricky. When the day came, I felt I was ready. I positioned myself about 200 feet shy of the finish line. That is about the limit. It takes about 15 grueling minutes to cover that distance. As I was walking, the announcer mentioned me several times to thunderous applause and cheering. Very exciting. During my walk, several Army National Guards people stood along the path and were cheering, clapping, and encouraging me to continue. When I finished the race and sat down, a woman handed me a rose. Don't know who she was. I had an official medal hung around my neck, which I have hanging on my wall right now. Then the most amazing, unexpected thing happened. An ABC reporter put a microphone right near my face and interviewed me for about 15 minutes. That night, I was on NBC News on the race recap for a very short period of time. Andy Warhol said back in the 50s that everybody in the future will have 15 minutes of fame. Well, over the next several years and since then, I've had more than my 15 minutes. In the following 4 years, actually, I invited more and more people to walk with me in the LA Marathon. In 2009, there were 14 of us. We called ourselves Team Rise Above. As the coordinator of the event, I became known as the captain. Every time I participated in a 5K, I would roll the course and then stand and walk the last couple hundred feet to cross the finish line, always to cheering and encouragement. Due to these accomplishments, I've been on TV and had several articles written about me. You can see these on the media tab on my website, spinalman.com. I set another goal a year ago when my left shoulder became too painful to push my manual wheelchair, causing me to go to the powered one that I use right now. The goal was to correct the problem and build my shoulder up so I can get back into using the manual chair again. The steps I took were to undergo surgery this January, then several months of rigorous physical therapy at regular intervals to build up the shoulder. I'm proud to say that in the next couple of weeks, I'll be back in my manual wheelchair. So next, maybe not the next meeting, but the meeting after that, I'll come here and you'll see I'll be in a different wheelchair. The next goal I set was to do something extreme. After talking with several friends, I chose to go soaring. Soaring is done in an engineless glider. So I can say that soaring is done in an engineless glider, brought up to several thousand feet by a tow plane, then untethered. Like many other sports, soaring is not set up for people with spinal cord injury. I had to be lifted into the glider and strapped in with a 5-point harness. I did this a month ago, and it was so exciting and extreme that I decided to memorialize the event with a video that I uploaded to YouTube and again put on my website, spinalman.com, under the Updates tab. The most recent goal I've set is to take the steps necessary to correct my posture, which, as you most likely have noticed, is poor. What I'm going to do is I'm going to be starting physical therapy, an intensive course of physical therapy for my back in a few weeks. Surgery is not in the works, but you never know what the future is going to hold. To summarize, pick an area to work on. Write it down, including the steps necessary to achieve the goal, then actually do it. And most important, make sure to reward yourself when you've actually reached the goal. My reward is sometimes a date with my wife, sometimes the purchase of something I've always wanted, and sometimes it's just psychic, just to feel like I've accomplished something. Following these steps, you'll be able to confidently go beyond your comfort zone or what other people have said you could or couldn't do. You'll feel better for having achieved your goal. Then you can set another one. Remember, the only time success comes before work is in the dictionary. People will recognize and notice your hard work and success, and you'll feel better about yourself. So, I challenge all of you to write down an achievable goal for yourself tonight.